key in the bustling village of Instow, famed for its golden sands, for its vendors of ale and ice cream, and for the wealth of its fabled population, aged population, I beg your pardon. Someone possessed a fabulous treasure chart. This is a story of the treasure, the story of the island where it lay hidden, and the story of the sailor who found it. His name? Robinson Crusoe! Yay! So please come with me down to the quay in Instow, where our adventure begins.
In South Australia I was born.
Heave away, haul away.
South Australia, round Cape Horn.
We're bound for South Australia. Heave away, you rolling pin. Heave away, haul away. All the way you'll hear me sing. We're bound for South Australia.
I walked out one morning there.
Heave away, haul away.
Just there I met Miss Nancy Blair.
We're bound for South Australia.
I shook her up, I shook her down.
Heave away, haul away.
I shook her round and round the town.
We're bound for South Australia. Heave away, you rolling king. Heave away, haul away. All the way you'll hear me sing. We're bound for South Australia.
There ain't but one thing grieves my mind.
Heave away, haul away.
Nancy Blair behind.
We're bound for South Australia.
As you wallop round Cape Horn,
heave away, haul away.
You wish to Christ you'd never be born.
We're bound for South Australia. Heave away, you rolling king. Heave away, haul away. All the way you'll hear me sing. We're bound for South Australia.
Bloody fool.
Oh, we're bound for South Australia.
I'm Devon born and Devon bred.
Heave away, haul away.
Long in the arm and thick
in the head. We're bound for South Australia. Heave away, you rolling king. Heave away, haul away. All the way you'll hear me sing. We're bound for South Australia.
Oh, rock and roll me over, boys.
Heave away, haul away.
Let's get this down, y'all.
It'll be time for me to sail on the Kathleen in May.
Oh, yes, Father. Mrs. Crusoe and I have been busy getting things ready in the galley.
I'm the captain, and I've told you 20 times. You and Mrs. Crusoe are not going.
But why not? We've been on every other voyage. What's so different about this one?
We're sailing to the West Indies. And you know what they're famous for?
They're famous for rum and sugar, and that's what you're going to bring back to Instow.
No, daughter. They're famous for pirates.
Pirates? That's just a silly story.
Do you want to be cut to pieces by a pirate's cutlass?
Oh, Father. I wonder what everyone else is doing. Buying last-minute things for the voyage, I expect. I wonder what Kenny Crusoe's buying.
Ah, here he is now. We'll soon find out.
Hello everyone, I'm Kenny Crusoe. Yes, my name is Kenny C. Crusoe. What's the C for? The ship's to sail on. What else do you think the C's for? You looking forward to the voyage, Polly?
I'm not letting my daughter and Mrs. Crusoe go on this voyage. And that is final.
Father, be reasonable. You know we can help you.
Father.
Well, I've been buying things for the voyage. And all good sailors take a parrot, don't they? Like the parrot? Going cheap at the market, he was.
Oh, I am not a parrot. I'm a puffin.
Are you? It is. It is a puffin. I've been had. That fella down at the market, he told me it was a parrot. And he even sold me this packet of special food. Still, I think I'll keep him. He is kind of cute, don't you think?
Yeah.
Well, I'd better go and pack the rest of my stuff for my voyage. I'll see you all later.
Bye! Bye.
Now, let's get one thing straight from the start. I'm Black Patch the Pirate. Now you, you're a load of stone wishwash. Don't you argue with me, mateys, or I'll come down there with me blunderbuss and blow your brains out. Well, I was hoping for some more noise than that. I just bought this down at Jones's. Well, I've been swindled. Grr, Chib lad, I've been swindled. And then the swindled Captain Black Patch lives to regret it. Now then, mateys, a pirate needs three things. A blunderbuss, a cutlass, and a parrot. Well, polish me, boot deck, there is a parrot.
Oh, I am not a parrot, I'm a puffin.
No.
Are you?
Hey, what do you think you're doing pinching my puffin? You great big stupid ignorant oaf! You clumsy clodder! I'm sorry, sir. I didn't mean it, sir. Not a word, sir.
You can help me, matey. Is that there ship ready to sail?
Yes, matey. Yes, matey.
And is it by any chance going to the West Indies? And is it by any chance going into far off Jamaica? Ah, that's 2,000 nautical miles. Nods to you.
Not you
too. I'm sick of a way of starting a mutiny on board. Yeah. Yeah, a mutiny. Tell me what you knows about the mutiny on the Bounty.
What?
Tell me about the Bounty.
Oh, well, it's made of coconut and it's covered in milk chocolate. And it's so sweet.
I'll cover you in milk chocolate and you get to threaten with me. And one more thing, matey, before he goes. You tells a living soul that you see me. And I'll have your guts for garters.
I won't tell a soul! Well, it was very nice meeting you and everything, but I have to go.
I'll tell you why I want to know if that ship's bound for far off Jamaica. Near Jamaica, there's some secret treasure. And I've heard on the pirate grapevine that there's a sailor what is here in Inchtown that's got the treasure chart. Now, I needs to get that treasure chart, because then I'll get the treasure. Because you see, I'm not only a pirate, I also dabbles in black magic. And this here book is my magic book. Don't believe me, mateys? Listen to this. Abracadabra, abracazee, signs of the zodiac, 1, 2, 3, spirits of evil, hearken to me. There, ladies, deadly nightshade, my favourite flower. Spirits of evil that we fear, that make the flower disappear. Now I must go, I must depart. I need to find that there treasure chart.
behind us. We are Bill and Ben.
The Flower Pot Men!
Why are two sailors like us Flower Pot Men?
Because we're potty!
Oh, will you shut up?
Don't hit me like that when I'm talking to my friends. Well, folks, it's fabulous seeing you all here tonight. It's really nice.
Shut your huge pipe!
I didn't...
Bang your hatches!
But I haven't...
Pull yourself together. If you're not careful, Captain Perkins won't take you on as a mate. Because as a sailor, you are useless.
I'm not.
All right, then. That ship over there. Tell me about the bulwarks. The starboard and port side.
Port side? We're going to eat it then.
Oh, no. We're not going to eat it. Port side is on the left. All right, then. Where are the bulwarks?
The bulwarks?
Yeah, the bulwarks.
Starbucks is on the right. Portsmouth is on the left. And in the middle is a little hut for... Funny little hut. For the cow.
Funny little hut for the cow? What are you talking about? A funny little hut for the cow?
It's where the bulwarks!
Where are the bulwarks?
Oh, Kenny! Hey, I'm surprised to see you two laugh, and I thought you didn't even want to go on this voyage.
We don't.
Then why'd you sign up?
Same reason as you!
You're gonna do dirty things.
You're going to do a dirty deed.
I'm not going to do dirty deeds, because dirty deeds are naughty.
Oh, no, they're not.
Are you going to hear the plot? Now, I'm going to stow away on board that ship. And when we get to Tobago, I hope to meet up with another ship. A pirate ship.
But where does the dirty deed come in?
You two are going to become pirates.
Me? A pirate?
Oh, it's easy. You just take the oath.
Where do I take it?
Oh, no, you don't take it anywhere.
Take the oath and you take it quick. Understand?
Quick, quick, clothes!
Oh, no!
Say after me, I swear.
I'm not going to swear.
I swear.
Damn!
No, swear properly, like a proper pirate. You raise your hand and you say the wicked word.
Niggers!
Say after me. I hereby swear.
I hereby swear.
I hereby swear.
That I will do dirty deeds.
That I will do dirty deeds.
That I will have dirty knees.
And laugh at the fishermen often.
And laugh at the fishermen often.
And the wimbles of what would do common.
To the best of my limited ability.
To the best of my limited ability.
To the best of my limited ability.
And be a crying disgrace and no use to anyone.
And be a crying disgrace and no use to anyone.
And a fine shoelace and a little dotty.
So long live lucrative piracy.
So long live Rupert of Piracy!
Well, now you two is sworn in, I'll take you for a drink down the boat. You understand your instructions? Come on then!
Signed
on
yet? I'm here.
Oh, and where's the signing on for?
I put them in my pocket. Or did I give them to my daughter? Perhaps they're over here.
Where's the pen? There's only one person who can fix this, and that's Robinson Crusoe.
Where is Robinson Crusoe?
Why don't we give him a call? Robinson!
Hello!
Morning, Joan. You coming on the voyage?
Hi, Robinson. Hi.
Great. You look well, Harry.
Thank you, Robinson.
And Captain
Perkins.
Oh, but what's wrong, Captain?
I've lost the signing on forms.
They're in your pocket. The pen's on the floor. I hope that's all you're worrying about.
No, it's not, Robinson. I'm worried about the pirates we keep hearing about.
We needn't worry about them, need we?
No.
We're all prepared, aren't we?
Yes!
Great. Then I must go and tell my mum that we'll be sailing soon. My mum loves ships. She spends hours and hours on the boating pool at Biddeford. Come on, let's find her. Mum!
Mrs. Crusoe!
Mrs.
Crusoe!
Shopping today!
Yes. Would you like one, dear? No, I want to. Oh, no, do take the wrapper off before you eat it, dear. Well, it looks like I'm going to be the ship's cooking in on this voyage. Something to the butcher's. I said, look, I'd like you to show me something nice, please. So he said, well, I can show you my kidneys. I said, no, I don't think I want to see your kidneys, thank you. I can show me a nice joint.
Oh, yes, yes.
Can you show me this? I said, how much? He said, £8.50. I said, £8.50 would have been cheaper to see your kidneys. So he said, well, would you prefer a bird? I said, well, I might. Shall you show me this? He said, I said, pull it. I said, pull it? I think I have to stuff it. Oh, look, I think it's laid an egg. Oh, no, it's a battery hen. Well, life's all go, isn't it? But I do love being a ship's cook and going away on voyages. But then I'll have to come home again to the seaside. Well, it's so friendly, isn't it, eh? Oh, would you like to be beside the seaside? Would you like to be beside the sea? Would you like to hear from the rock? Sang. Now listen, you lot, I'm Chrissy Crusoe and I'm singing about our seaside here. So when I get to that bit about where the brass band plays tiddly-om-pom-pom, I want you lot to be the brass band and go tiddly-om-pom-pom. So we'll practice that one, right? After three. Three! Where the brass band plays
tiddly-om-pom-pom!
I can't hear you!
There's
the rafters in hell, right for all! After three! Three! Where the brass band play
tiddly-om-pom-pom!
Oh, fantastic! You're not just a brass band, you're the Liverpool Philharmonic! Oh. Now look, we're all going to join in and sing about a seaside now. Come on, darlings! All together! Woo!
Oh, who like to be beside the seaside? Who like to be beside the sea?
Creature will steal your money.
You mean George Osborne?
I mean pirates. You two are not sailing, and that's final.
What'll we do?
Don't worry, Polly. I'll get us on board that ship if it kills me. We'll think of something. Don't worry.
Women.
Lightning! excellent.
Oh, it's old Jim. Why weren't you signing on?
Oh, seafaring's finished for this old sea dog.
Oh, but I'll look after you like I always do.
And I you've always been very kind to me, you has.
Nonsense.
Yeah, but it's because of this kindness, see, I've got a little something for you, Robinson.
Oh, I don't want anything from you. You're my friend.
Aye, and a friend must help a friend.
The treasure chart of London. The great Scott, so you're its owner.
Aye, and Jeremy Timbers, there's no one in the whole world that deserves it more than he.
Oh, Jim, if I find the treasure, I'll give you half, I promise.
I won't be here, matey. I'll be dead and gone. Read it to me so I can hear them secret words one last time.
Captain Kidd's treasure.
Treasure chart on Lundy, hey? Not Tobago after all. How can I steal that chart? I know, I'll hide away on board and buy me time. Robinson Crusoe's not the only one bound for Lundy. I'm horrible, hideous, moody, and mean, so I'll climb aboard. I'm always there.
May God bless you, shipmate, and may the Northern Star watch over you.
The chart! I can't believe it. We're going to be rich. I must call everybody. Everybody, look! It's the treasure chart of Lundy. Gold, silver, diamonds. Captain Perkins, will you let us all stop off at Lundy, because that's where the treasure is?
Well, it's en route to Jamaica, but I don't know. Alright, alright.
Hooray! Then goodbye, Robinson, darling. Goodbye, Polly. Don't worry about me.
Then goodbye, Captain darling!
Goodbye, Chrissy. Don't worry about me.
Oh, my
someone new. She sure looks happy, I sure am blue.
He was my baby till she stepped in. That was the romance that might have been.
And here's the reason that I'm
to sleep until dawn.
And what have you got in these bags, Mrs. Crusoe? They're very heavy.
Oh, just a few beauty products, dear. Us girls have got to look our best, haven't we? Especially for sailing.
Orders. It's £20.
£20? But I can't pay that!
Polly, go to your cabin. I want to sort this out with Mrs. Crusoe.
Mrs. Crusoe, I'm so sorry. Perhaps you can borrow the money from someone.
What a nice girl, dear Polly is. But I wouldn't have the cheek to borrow 20 quid from anybody. I wouldn't have the nerve. It would be awful. Can I borrow 20 quid?
Certainly not.
So stern, the way you say it. So stern, so masterly.
Masterly?
Yes, masterly. Just like Captain Hulk, he who discovered Ambrosia.
You mean Captain Cook, who discovered Australia?
Yes, well, like him as well. He was masterly, but he was generous. Oh, always lending people money. He was, oh, smashing fella. Everybody loved him because he was lending people money and he was generous. And you know, people love you when you're generous. Oh, you know, you're so attractive and fascinating. Just turn your head that way. Do you know, you've got a nose just like Basil Brush.
Oh, Chrissy, I was wondering if you felt that way about me. You little devil, you drive me mad.
He fancies me. If I play the cards right now, you'll let me the 20 quid. And just watch this. Now, I know the crew, your crew, call you Captain Perkins, but I've got a new name for you.
What's that?
George Clooney!
Oh, getting on a bit, isn't he?
Yes, but he's still very handsome, attractive and alluring.
Oh, Chrissy. Oh, Chrissy Crusoe.
Oh, George!
Hey, I've lent you the money.
Well, don't you trust me?
I'm sorry, Chrissy, but I just don't like lending money like this.
Oh, I ever not?
Well, what proof have I got that you'll ever pay me back?
Well, all right, how's an IOU?
What's an IOU?
Now you see why my son Robinson is really in charge of this ship. He may be the captain, but he's a bit thick, isn't he, really? An IOU is a piece of paper that states that one person owes the other person a sum of money.
I'm so dizzy at the very thought of you. I can't concentrate on what you're saying.
It's easy. I will write out the IOU. I have a piece of paper here. May I borrow a pencil?
Certainly.
Thank you. Thank you. I owe you 20 pounds.
That's my IOU, isn't it?
Yes, that's your IOU. And as it's your IOU, you, of course, have to sign it.
Of course. Captain Perkins.
Oh, well, that wasn't too hard, was it? Good day to you. Thank you.
Hey, just a minute. You must think me a mug.
Me? Think you a mug? Why should I think you a mug? He's got me now, I'm at it now!
Why should you think me a mug? Because you've still got my pencil!
I've been keeping an eye on that ship from my high deck down below. Now night has fallen, it's time to signal. I am a pirate and needs help. Oh, curses, they haven't seen me. Oh, yes, they have. I am Jack Boot. Jack Boot, tickle me tonsils. We sail together under Captain Kidd.
Is that you?
Oh, Jack Boot. He's an old mate of mine. Attack this ship when we reaches Lundy. Okay, we'll do. Over and out. To take over this here ship will soon be my pleasure. Then we lands on Lundy and digs up the treasure.
Robinson!
always imagining things.
It's true, isn't it true?
Yes!
You mean a real pirate?
Yes!
On board?
Yes!
But who is he?
Backscratch.
He's who? He's who?
Backscratch!
Backpatch!
Backpatch!
Backpatch! Bad pirate! And he signaled to a pirate ship that's going to attack us!
Then we must go and tell your father. Just a minute. We must tell Captain Perkins to pretend nothing is happening. That will allay suspicion.
Keep to the normal ship's routine.
Yes, but we'll tell him to alert everyone to let the crew be secretly at the ready.
Okay, but Robinson, I'm scared.
Don't be alarmed, Polly. I'll look after you. Come on, cheer up.
Near the island and village. 10 paces north, 6 paces south, 40 paces. Yeah, I've got all that. Now I don't need that blasted chart, because I know the way to the treasure by heart. Here!
You read the chart?
What chart?
You're holding it in your hand? What's the matter with him?
He looks like he's been hypnotised.
Hey! Don't laugh at the afflicted, because I have been hypnotised. I'm serious.
What are you talking about?
Well, I'll tell you. It was like
Abracadabra, abracadee! Turn into a statue just for me!
I'm not going to tell them this time.
He's become gormless.
Oh no, he always looks like that.
Poor blooming cheek.
Robinson, there's something very strange going on.
Yes. How are you, lazy landlubbers? Volunteers! Where's my volunteers? You all know who I am, don't you?
Yes, Captain Bly!
I'm the captain, all right. And you're my crew. And you're all here to do mop drill. This ship needs cleaning. It's filthy. What is it?
It's filthy.
Correct. So the deck, the stem and the stern, mop it!
What?
Mop it! I want discipline on board the Kathleen and May. She's a fine ship. Now, where's the crew mustard?
I am. I'm an old soap, but I'm mustard all right.
Look at you. You're all a complete shambles. What are you?
Complete shambles!
Louder!
Complete shambles!
So pull yourselves together. Throws up!
Surprise attack! Now, are your stout lads all ready?
Aye, ready, willing, and able.
So, this is Robinson Crusoe's ship.
I'll cut his gizzard.
I'll waddle his windpipe.
What we want is a nice, juicy murder.
Shush, quietly, my lads, quietly. Sound at all, we never say a word. A fly's foot would be distinctly heard.
Skillfully the fire creeps while all the house so softly sleeps.
Skillfully the fire creeps while all the house so softly sleeps.
Sink a couple of ships a week. Hello there, what is this song I sing? And live and die a pirate king. For I am a pirate king.
You are a pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
Yes,
I don't think so.
No!
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 and the pyramid's curse. No. Abracadabra and abracadee, ease for escape, and now I set you free. Yeah! It is magic.
Yes, baby, it is magic. Now you can do me another good turn. Turn to the letter S.
Letter S?
No!
What does that stand for?
S is for shipwreck. Abracadabra, abracadee, spirits of evil, hearken to me. Come ye forth from the mighty deep, through the oil and slime you creep.
Robinson! Help me, Robinson!
What's the matter? Black merchant free? And what's that black ship?
That black ship is what we pirates likes to call an oil tanker, matey.
It's an evil-looking ship.
And there's a banner being waved. And on the banner, it says WC.
Yes, there's a flag of convenience.
Flag of convenience? Oh, no!
Robinson, stop him!
Yes!
No! Because this is where I get you two mateys under my spell. I've sailed in great big galleons. I've sailed in a little skiff. Now you two rapscallions, may your feet be frozen stiff! My slimy friends will ram this ship. You're powerless to stop them. The stormy seas and jagged rocks will send you to the bottom!
I hope you've got your raffle tickets and had a glass or two of wine.
Yeah.
Well done. I am the Panto Fairy.
All
sparkling, sweet and light. And I come from a shiny place where all is clean and bright. My name is Dita Genta. But here there's one that's brighter. It's just my luck on the storm-tossed isles.
That
Ariel washes whiter. There was a time when I'd appear to dance and sing for you, but now they've sent me out in this to introduce Act Two.
Oh, yay!
We left our hero and his crew beset by gales and lightning. On stormy seas, the tempest was quite frightening. The evil pirate Black Patch sank the Kathleen May and left you all agog and wondering as to who would save the day. Well, it was precious little magic things with my new wand, bright and shiny, that saved brave Robinson and his friends from the blustery brine. I calmed the angry, raging seas with a dainty wave of hand and conjured up a gentle breeze to bring them to dry land. Now here on Lundy Island, there's treasure, adventure and more. So come along with me, my dears, and find out what's in store.
It's the way that you do it. That's what gets results.
It ain't what you do, it's the time that you do it. It ain't what you do, it's the time that you do it. It ain't what you do, it's the time that you do it. That's what gets results. Results. I thought I was smart, but I soon found out I didn't know what life was all about. And then I learned, I must confess, life is like a game of chess. It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it. It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it. It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it. That's what gets results.
I've walked about for hours on this shore. I rescued my rusty trifle from the shipwreck and with it some ammunition. But after the various exertions, I'm tired.
Aww.
A footprint. Then there are others on this island. But this is the print of a bare foot. A large foot. Drumbeats. Are they natives or are they cannibals? I must hide.
Shacks the size of buses, and bite a man in two. And 15 species of giant snakes that can crush a man to death.
I could do all of that, don't you know?
Well then, we've got great big hairy spiders and thousands of poisonous little biters.
Oh, we don't like spiders!
You wouldn't like these little beauties, I can tell you. They wait there hiding a danny, wait till you start to do your business, and they leap up and bite you on the bum.
Oh, enough! I'm fed up with listening to your egotistical, antipodean animal anecdotes.
That's downright rude, lady. Fair dinkum. I'm gonna cark it. I want you to know I'm not afraid of you.
Cark it? I will. You're looking fine fettled to me.
And you gonna eat me then?
Eat you? No, we're not going to eat you. We're vegetarians.
Vegetarians? Strength, that's disgusting. Well, if you ain't gonna eat me, what are you gonna do to me?
Work it out, Wonderbrain. We've been on this island for 5 long years. And it's been a long time since we've seen a bloke. How long has it been, girls?
It's been 3 years, Majesty.
And 11 weeks.
And 5 days.
What happened to the other bloke then? Help!
Stop! Now I'll scare the life out of you, bloodthirsty lot.
I don't know what those villains think they were up to, but...
You don't want to know a young lad like you. But thanks, guys. You got me out of a fix there, right enough. It's true.
Pleased to have been of help. I'm Robinson Crusoe, and this is my brother, Kenny.
How do you do?
Nice of you to ask, young Ken. I was doing right till those crazy shears caught up with me. To frighten the life out of me when the boss lady with a face like a drop of pie started talking about mating and weddings.
What have you been living on? You look into how long have you been on the island? You look in a terrible state with your ripped clothing, and you'll be glad of a shave and a haircut.
I always look like this.
Beg your pardon.
That's all right, Rob. Now I got washed up on my board on Friday. I was staying at Westford Ho, Bayview Road, and went out to catch a few waves, but the surf was a bit flat. I saw some right beauties out of that bath in here.
What, you surfed the bar?
That's right, young Ken. Some old timer on my orange tug out there shouted out at me. I should have listened to him. Next thing I knew, I was being tossed around like a wombat in a washing machine and ended up on this island. What a drongo.
But what have you been living on?
Grass, seaweed, parrot eggs. Just like this little fella here.
I'm not a parrot, I'm a puffin.
Fair to make wind your neck in. Anyway, as I was saying, plays hell with indigestion. What we know Danny paper on this wretched island, it's been awful. What I wouldn't give, be able to throw a few snags on the barbie, crack open a few tinnies, and eat until I was as full as a centipede sock drawer. Anyway, enough about me. How come you two are here?
We've been shipwrecked.
Shipwrecked? True. Where'd you sail from?
Well, we sailed from the bustling seaside village of Instow. Famed for its golden sands, prosperous vendors of ale and ice cream, and the fabled wealth of its aged population.
It's true. Never heard of it, mate.
You're not from around here, are you, Mr...
Call me Cobber. No, you're right, Chunk Ken. I'm not from around here. I come from a place thousands of miles away. From Australia.
Australia?
Australia. Place of cricket, kangaroos, sheep. Sheilas. Marsupials, mosquitoes. And Matilda.
Once a jolly swagman camped down by the billabong, under the shade of a coolabah tree. And he sang as he watched, and he waited till his billy boy, who'll come about sing Matilda with me. Sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag. Have a waltz, sing Matilda with me.
Waltz, sing Matilda, waltz, sing Matilda, waltz, sing Matilda.
Christmas.
Took all the women. Once I bought the lugger, and the girl is mine. Always up to some wicked scrape, weren't we, mateys? Now, as far as this wicked scheme goes, we need to get the Queen on our side, see?
I'm with you all the way, Captain.
Then she could show us where the treasure is.
You're crafty, Captain Kidd.
Well, she can take us to the Rugby Rock, because that's where the treasure's buried, see?
We'll be rich beyond the dreams of Avocado. Captain, everything you do is a success. From port to starboard.
From the rigging to the rudder. Robinson Crusoe and his stupid friends are in for some bad luck.
How do you know?
Just now I see a great big albatross flying round the island.
Are albatross unlucky?
They are if you stand underneath them.
Very unlucky. So now's the time to chat up the Queen.
But what are we going to give the Queen for showing us the treasure?
Oh. Treasure?
Simple, matey. We give her Robinson Crusoe's guns.
Robinson Crusoe's guns?
But where does he keep them?
Well, he rescued them from the shipwreck and stored them in the stockade.
So, we're going to creep into the stockade.
Give the guns to the villagers.
And that will be that!
Yeah! And Robinson Crusoe!
And Polly Perkins!
And the captain!
And Mrs. Crusoe! And Jenny Crusoe!
No! Oh well! They're gonna kill us all!
Oh, hang up! Here comes the Queen!
We'll soon come back!
Well, hello! What can I do for you?
We're hoping you can help us, matey.
I'm not matey, I'm the Queen. And what's in it for me?
Well, we'll pay you good money, Queenie.
Money? Money? Money's no good to me. You'll have to do better than that.
Leave this to me. I'll soon have her eating out of my hand. Would guns be better?
Oh yes, guns would be very good. I am gold.
Gold?
Diamonds and emeralds.
All right, there's plenty to go round.
Cream cakes.
You never said anything about the cream cakes, Captain.
That's because there are no cream cakes. Now then, Queenie, you take us to the Rugged Rock and we'll share the treasure with you.
Sounds fair to me.
Robinson Crusoe and his friends must be defeated.
And Robinson and his friends have built a stockade. Now are you and your people going to help us attack that stockade?
Glad to. If we can take the men back to our village.
What? No?
No.
It's a deal, Majesty, your old matey.
Less of the old, matey.
And long live lucrative piracy.
No.
Long live lucrative piracy.
Soon be rich, mate. You work all night, you work all day to pay the bills you have to pay. Ain't that sad? It seems more sensible to be a nasty pirate just like me. I'm so bad. For in my heart, I really am a very wicked, greedy man. I'll help myself, I'll steal it all, I'll grab the love and have a ball. Money, 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 must be funny in a rich man's world. Money, 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 always sunny in a rich man's world. Ah, 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 ah.
treasure trove is hard to find, and I can't get it off my mind. Ain't that sad? This gold and silver of Lundy is waiting out there just for me. I'm so bad, for in my heart I really am a very wicked, greedy man. I'll help myself, I'll steal it all, I'll grab the lot and have a ball. Money, money, money must be funny in a rich man's world. Money, 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 always sunny in a rich man's world. Ah, all the things I could do if I had a little money in a rich man's world. In a rich man's world.
But if you stand too close to him, you can hear the ocean.
Oh, that's better.
Whoa!
What do you see now?
Here, Kenny, have a look.
Oh, well, they're better dressed than last night's crowd. But hey, there's a rough-looking lot at the back.
Every Bedford Club, Bridge Club, Rotary.
But no ships, and better still, no pirates.
Oh, I don't want to see that captain back scratch again.
Oh. Well, perhaps he drowned in the shipwreck.
Why are pirates called pirates?
They just are.
Here, I know a good one. What has eight legs and eight eyes?
I don't know. What has eight legs and eight eyes?
Eight pirates!
Okay. Why does it take pirates so long to learn the alphabet?
I don't know. Why does it take pirates so long to learn the alphabet?
Because they spend years at sea!
I got one. What do you get if you cross a cat with a parrot?
I don't know, what do you get if you cross a cat with a parrot?
A carrot!
Oh, a carrot.
Oh, is that your tummy rumbling, Kenny?
Oh, I don't know, I blocked wind last night.
Oh, trust me, Ben, it wasn't trapped.
Well, I'm so hungry that last night I was dreaming of Mrs. Crockley's cheese biscuits.
We could eat the parrot!
Bob! I am not a parrot, I'm a puffin!
We could eat the puffin then! A Piffer's puffin!
A double egg for a puffin!
Hey! You're not eating my puffin!
No.
But we can send for supplies.
I don't see how.
Well, we'd write a list, put it in a bottle, and hope that the current carries it to the mainland.
Currents! I like currents! Can we order some current buns, please? Can we go and order it now?
We can go when the captain takes watch.
But I'm not wearing a watch!
And no, it means... Oh, never mind, here comes the captain now. Oh! Here comes the captain now!
Thank you, Kenny. I'll take over now. I'm thirsty. What I wouldn't give for a nice cold beer in the boathouse.
G'day, mate. I thought all you pommies liked your beer warm.
Who are you? Where do you spring from?
Call me Cobber. I bumped into your pals, Rob and young Ken, back along. They sent me to find you. You must be the captain.
Thank goodness. For a minute there, I thought you were a cannibal.
A cannonball?
No, I said cannibal.
Sorry, mate, you're going to have to speak English. Didn't quite get what you're trying to say there.
I am speaking English, you wormy ticket. I said cannibal.
Ah, got you, mate. Nah, I like me meat like any right-thinking bloke. I'm not a cannibal. What made you think that?
Well, I've heard the islanders are cannibals.
Nah, they're not cannibals. I've met them. It's worse than that.
What could be worse than cannibals?
They're vegetarians.
God gracious.
And feminists.
Shiver me timbers. I'm sorry about the misunderstanding, Cobber.
It's all right, Captain. It's always happening to me.
Is it really?
Yeah, why? Back along in Devon, I was at a beach party, trying to impress a young Sheila. We were chilling around the fire, cracking open a few tinnies, toasting a few mallows, sun was setting. You get the picture?
I think so.
I thought she looked at me a bit sideways when I suggested she slipped her thongs off to feel the warm sand under her skin. I was just airing me romantic side, you know. Then she took off like a frog in a sock. And I asked her if she'd like to blow on me, did you do? Women, eh?
I've just been checking all the guns, but what's happening out there?
Well, there's no one out there, Robinson.
Well, they'll be here soon enough. Still, the stockade's nearly finished. We just need some food to store in there.
Bonzer, what's that?
Oh, I do hope Cobber's going to enjoy life when we get back to Instow after all our adventures.
Well, I've explained to him that it never stops raining and that we British are mad.
Woodrums! Get everyone! Hey everyone, check your guns are safe.
Quick, before the islanders return. Quick, right, Captain, by the gates of the stockade.
Aye, aye, right, Robinson.
Cobber, there. Little Red, stand there. Kelly, there. Polly, stay by me, stay by me.
They're behind you.
Something's wrong. It's what? Everything's gone quiet. What can you see, Captain?
I don't understand. They've all gone.
It's a trick. I'm sure it's a trick.
Oh, Robinson Crusoe, oh, save me. Oh, the islanders are coming back. Oh, help me, matey, help me.
No, Polly, it's not a trick. Quick, Captain, open the gate for Black.
No!
It's a
sledging before I bait you over here.
Just another windy pop.
Ah, well here comes me doodra. Quick, quick.
Cobber, come on, get up.
Now you've had your chips.
You never told me anything about chips.
Chips, I like chips.
Oh, quiet. There are no chips. Well, Robinson Crusoe, we meet again.
Only this time, you better say your prayers.
Especially you, you little lass. Now we're up to the rugged rock to stick up all the treasure. But we ain't going alone, are we, Jack Boone?
Not us, shipmates.
No. We need a little female company.
No.
And you're the little female. And a smithereens. Well, my name's not Bartholomew Blackpatch. Don't he move or I'll make mincemeat out of you. Now, come on, Jack Boot. We'll soon find that treasure. Step me, boys. This way, Polly Perkins, Mickey.
And now, foolish men, your time has come. It's been 3 years, Majesty, and he never
and 6 days.
I was dead scared until you arrived.
All that worry's given me a terrible headache.
Well, you won't find any aspirins on this island.
Why not?
The paracetamol! The paracetamol!
When I see someone like you standing up to the islanders, I begin to understand what feminism and women's labour is all about.
Hooray! Oh, us women can do far better than men, can't we, girls? Yay! Us women on the attack now!
Yes, women like you are revolting.
You cheeky monkey! Women like me are revolting. I've never been so insulated in all my life. What a thing to say!
Past the village and the windswept tree, then we went north. That's it. We are very near.
Where?
There's fair, Queenie. I gave you all a men. Now you give me the beautiful treasure.
I don't know where the treasure is. I told you I'd bring it to the rugged rock. Well, there's the rugged rock. I don't know where the treasure is.
You know all right. You can't fool Captain Blackpatch and me, your majesty, matey. You can't call a callous and crafty cutthroat whose charismatic career is covered in cruelty and cunning. Now can you, matey? So, where's the treasure?
There are the rocks. Go and look in them.
Typical man can't find a thing.
On the rocks, hey?
The treasure of Lundy.
The treasure of Lundy. Delicious. Oh, come on, little matey. Don't you want a pretty little necklace around that beautiful throat of yours?
No, I want a rope around that ugly, unwashed neck of yours.
You're like a tiger, just how I like my women.
What is that called of me?
But you're going to become Mrs. Blackpatch.
No!
Well, it sounds better than Mrs. Robinson Crusoe, doesn't it? Shut up. Come on, you landlubbers. And you, your majesty, matey. And you, jackboot, waiting for your booty, are you? I...
Wouldn't...
Come on!
I don't know what to make of Captain Blackpatch.
He's just a big bully.
Jackboot is about as popular as a rattlesnake in a lucky dip. Here's me blowpipe with a dart in it. This is for you, fella.
To lads like you, but fight pirates like me.
Yes! This!
Wow! That hurt.
You bloodthirsty fucker here.
Oh, I hate you, Robinson Crusoe. And we fight to the death.
To the death. And the death will be yours.
Oh, there you are, Kennedy!
Thank you.